So we're going to chant now. Om Namo Gurudev Namo. Say that with me. Om Namo Gurudev Namo.
Om Namo Gurudev Namo.
And before we do that, we're going to chant Om Ganesha. Can you chant that?
Om Ganesha.
And then Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
Om Gam Ganapataye Namaha.
Very good.
You're almost better off not reading, my opinion, and just listening and feeling the sound and catching what and repeating. But if you want to read, go ahead. But.
So Kirtan's all about, there's so many new people, and already you don't, this does not feel new to any of you. So your souls know this experience. That's what it feels like to me. And you'll find Om Ganesha and Om Namo most likely on the very front page, because generally speaking, this is our invocation. This is Om Namo Gurudev Namo, is I call on the divine light, I call on the teacher within. And Om Ganesha, who knows who Ganesha is? Ganesha is this guy down here, yeah? So the thing that we need to know about Ganesha is it's not like we're giving praise to something outside of ourselves. Anytime we use the name of a deity, anytime that we chant to a particular deity, we're chanting to the essence and the quality of that particular beingness, and not outside of ourselves, but within us. It's very important. So when we chant to Ganesha, Ganesha is like the remover of all obstacles. And how I feel that inside myself is that we are limitless. We're limitless creatures. We have no limits. And so to chant to Ganesha awakens that truth and that potential within us, that we are completely limitless. And there are no such thing as obstacles, as long as we're walking our truth and being in our authenticity and being our light. So that's why we chant to Ganesha, and that's why we chant Om Namo Gurudev Namo. And I call on, I bow to, I honor the divine light.